Hi, welcome to this session about contributing to the Eclipse BERT project. So you want to contribute to the BERT project. So you want to fix bugs or add new features. And this session will tell you how you can set up your development environment. So the project is hosted on eclipse.org/BERT. And our sources and issues are on GitHub, github.com/eclipsebert. So the first thing you do is you go to the github.com/eclipsebert repository, and you are going to make a fork. So you fork it to your own GitHub account, and that will be finished in a couple of seconds. So you can also clone the main repository, but you cannot push to that, right? So that's the reason why you have to make a fork, so that you can push your changes to your fork and then create a pull request. But I will show you how to do that a little bit later in this video. So you take this URL, copy it in your clipboard, or yeah, you remember it. And then when you scroll down, you will find the Eclipse, the create an Eclipse development environment link. So here is a link, create an Eclipse development environment. But before you can actually click this link, you have to install the Eclipse installer. So if you go there, you can also see dedicated development environment, please read the tutorial. So it says here, install using auto launch. The Eclipse installer can be launched automatically when clicking a link on a web page. So let's go to the Eclipse installer, download the Eclipse installer for Windows 64-bit. So let's do that first. So we're going to save this file, and then we're going to go to our downloads and run the Eclipse installer. So the Eclipse installer can be used to install any Eclipse IDE flavor, but we are going to use it to install a complete development environment. And for that, we go to the hamburger menu and click on web links. The installer can be registered to handle web links only if it's kept in a permanent location. Do you wish to proceed to with making it permanent? We say, yeah, we want to do that. And this has now been done. Okay, so we go back to the to our previous website that we clicked from our README file. Okay, so let's back up a little bit. So I'm now in my BERT fork. And going now a little bit below, we can see create development environment. So when I click on that, now I can click my launch button. Because the Eclipse installer link has now been associated with the Eclipse installer. So I press launch, choose application, and then I can select the Eclipse installer. So I open that link. There is an installation folder name where the installation is going to be created. You can tick show all variables to, for example, find the root installation folder and some other stuff. And also what you see here is that the BERT GitHub repository is now set to Eclipse BERT Git. But you can change this here into your fork. And then also put any GitHub user ID and any other content that is not added here. You can add that. And then go to next. And then press finish. You can check this button, dismiss automatically. When this installer is done, then it will automatically close. Otherwise, it stays open. It's a little bit confusing. So just check that button. As you can see here, it is now downloading Eclipse. It's creating a complete new installation environment for you. You can see there's a bunch of things that are going to happen here. And after that is done, an Eclipse will be launched automatically. And then the setup, the installer will be invoked again to do setup things, for example, like cloning the Git repository. So I'm going to leave this running. And now the Eclipse IDE is launched. And after it is launched, it will start the installer again so that the installer can do some configuration of this Eclipse instance. So you can see here below. And also here you can do dismiss automatically and restart automatically if needed. And you can see it now fetches from my fork instead of from the main repository. So that was the effect of changing that variable. And when I take a look on my file system, the base directory was apps, Eclipse, oomph, and then Birdmaster. And when I go in there, then here's the Eclipse installation. This is the repository, and this is the workspace being used for development. The Git repository is quite big, so if you have a slow connection, it can take a while. Okay, the installer is working on importing all the projects. And now we set up a BERT target, and a BERT target is the complete compilation environment. All the dependencies that we need to work with BERT are in a target file, and this target file is now being resolved. Okay, setting the Java 11 target and then creating working sets. Okay, so then everything is configured. I can now actually close the welcome screen and you see that in the background Eclipse is compiling everything. So we have to wait for the compile process to complete and after that we can start developing. So let's see. Let's wait for the compile to complete. Okay, so one of the things that you might notice is the huge amount of warnings. One of the things that that is, let's say, low-hanging fruit to help in increase the quality of the BERT project is to help us get rid of these warnings, right? So basically you go in and say, okay, version constraints missing and all that kind of stuff maybe we can get rid of by either suppressing the warning or by actually fixing it in the code. But now we have our BERT development environment set up. Inside the BERT bundles, these are all the BERT bundles, and you can now make changes in any of these projects. We have tests as well. Number of tests are available. Not all the tests are valid at the moment. We are still working on that. That also something that you could do to help us is fix the tests. And basically these are all the BERT projects that we have today. Okay, so how do I test my changes, right? So suppose I am in some kind of BERT core UI class and I go into the source here And there's this error dialogue, and I have made a nice change to this error dialogue. How do I really test this, this change? Well, for that we have a so-called launch configuration or run configuration. So you go to this this dropdown, and you go to the run configurations, and inside the, let's say, the installed bird, there are now two run configurations available. One for running bird in an all-in-one mode, right? That's one of the products of bird where we just run with everything. So if I run this, then bird will be started, and you can just check the result of your change. Okay, so now a new Eclipse is started, but this time with an embedded bird. So you just go in and you find the reporting perspective, the report designer perspective. Here it is. Yeah, and then you can create a project. So you can create a bird project over here. So we'll call it test. And then we have the test bird project. So now we can create a report, new report design. And then we can actually create a report here. Hello world. Save the report and then preview it. And yeah, so the report viewer at the moment is not functioning. We're getting a 404 error. Also something, if you have experience with Jetty and servlets, then please help us fix this. This is a really big requirement before we can actually release Bird. But otherwise, yeah, it is fully functional and it looks great. So you can just start developing. Now for the tests, there are at the moment four tests that are functional, and we have a run configuration for one of the tests. So that is for the you go back to the run configuration. And we have the bird model test. One thing that you should know about test is that there is always an all tests class that you want to run. And that will take care of running all the tests in that specific project. So the project is the model tests project. And the test class is the all tests. If you want to create a launch configuration or a unit test configuration, you just change the project into another project and then point to the correct all tests class, and that will run that test. Okay, so let me see what that looks like when I run this test. All these dependency stuff we are working on. Also, if you want to take a look at that, file an issue and fix it. So the test will take a little while to start up, to set up the test environment, but the actual tests, they will be very quick. There you go. So this test has been have been run. These tests are also run when you make a pull request. So let's take a look at how we do that. Okay. So suppose I'm going to make a change in this error dialog, right? So let's just say I can see here, missing comment for public declaration. So I can now I make a Java doc comment here. Java doc comment for this field. Okay, one of the warnings that we can now fix. So I'm going to save this. Then I'm going to open my Git staging view. So this is the change that I made. In your commit message, make sure that you put in the title of the issue. Okay, so I'm going back to the Bird website. So eclipse.org, sorry, github.org eclipse bird. I'm going to take a look at my issues. So for every pull request, we need to have an issue, right? So that we know what has been fixed in a specific release. So for example, let me just say that I'm going to do it for this issue. I can click on this issue, and then I'm going to copy everything, including the number, and then I'm going to paste that inside the first line of the commit message. And then I say edit some Java documentation. Okay, so make sure that your author and committer are correct. These need to be matched with GitHub, but also with your Eclipse contributor agreement, right? So you need to sign the Eclipse contributor agreement that is also in the README file of the GitHub repository. So I'm going to commit and push here. I should have made a different branch, right? But I'm going to push it to my own repository anyway. So now it is being pushed to my repository. So if I now go there, now let me just get this URL. This will now go to our internal web browser, but in later versions of Eclipse, this will actually open a the normal web browser. So let's go there. So I go in here and I paste my URL. So sorry, I have to get rid of my username over there. So here it says this branch is one commit ahead of Eclipse Master. So now I can say contribute, and I can create a pull request in the original, in the master repository. So here we have a pull request. It tells me what I have done. And then I can create a pull request stating that I want to merge my change from my repository into master. So let's do that. So it already puts in my commit, and then I can create a pull request. And this is in the Eclipse Bird repository. So what happens here, everything is going to be compiled, our tests are going to be run, and the committers of the Bird project will take a look and then finally import this this change in the master repository. So yeah, I'm actually not going to do that. So I'm going to quickly close this pull request. And that is basically the whole cycle. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed it. We're looking forward to see you and your changes in the Bird repository. Okay, later.